Okay, so I was talking about getting a sorting house. Let's see here. There we go. Put that down there. And a smoke... I mean, we might as well put the smokehouse down as well. We're going to be making use of those anyway. Ah, the dairy parlour. So that's where we'll be making the various milk products, well, the dairy products, will I say. And we're already producing milk, so we can actually put one of those down. Just to see how it works. That's going to be... like that, is it? Yeah, we'll put two down. We'll see how that goes. And, of course, more roads. There we go. Almost. Okay, yeah, we're done. My word, yeah, starvation is actually becoming an issue again. So... yeah. My word, yeah, that's just suddenly dropped off, and I'm fairly certain that was just because we lost the roof cellar and the grain silo when we did. Oh, here we go. Now, what can you make? Oh, you can make haggis with mutton cuts, onion, salt, and barrel. Make brined cheese and barrels. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. We can make cheese from one of the dairy parlours. Assuming that they'll actually work on it. Right, let's go help that along. You know, I think I might bump these fields back up to four because I have noticed that they're always leaving a strip or two for the harvests. Yeah, the starvation is really starting to hit. Although, that was a couple of old age deaths. Oh, but that was a starvation as well. That's not good. Food is low. Yeah, I know. Doing what we can, but apparently not enough. Oh, this is a real death spiral now. the parlours. Is up and running. And there's the other one. Max these out. It's not dead yet, Jim, but it could go that way very soon. Can make smoked cheese. Pemmican. Pemmican wouldn't be too bad for us right now. Yeah, we'll make that for now. Okay, there we go. The dairy sheds are ready. Smokehouse has a lot of walking to do to actually bring in the venison cuts, but I mean, for the time being, that's fine. Now, what can we make here? Healing poultice, honey, bone meal, and cloth. Works for me. I still don't know where we're getting the bone meal from, but we are producing it somewhere. If anyone knows where it's coming from, do let me know. That's full. That's reached its production limit. We're still having issues with furniture and silverware. Is there a storage facility for milk? I have no idea. But we could definitely use it. Food cellar would work. Not sure. But we'll give it a go. We'll stick it back here just as a test. So they got the logs, they got the barrels, they got the salt. Now they're just waiting for the meats. Speaking of which, hunters' cabins, how are you doing? Ah, okay, so the bone meal is coming from the hunters. Right, well, that's good to know. Venison is coming in. Venison butcher here. You are still waiting on it, apparently. My word. That's a very full market. And this market's pretty full up as well. And it's filled with tin as well. I didn't want that. In that case, we were thinking about the tinneries. So, why not? Put a tinnery right here. A meat tinnery. We'll see how that goes for the time being. And plan accordingly. Once again, get the stone roads up and out. This is a building that lets us make a crossroads in it, so gonna make use of that. I know the colonists will. It looks like the salting house managed to get some produce. Maybe not. Another death to starvation. Yeah, we are really, really starting to suffer here. Yeah, there's got to be some kind of bottleneck happening somewhere. I'm wondering if these markets have taken in too many goods and are now blocked up so they can't take in food. Let's see if I can remedy that at all. No, I don't want a stockpile, I want actual storage sheds. Fabrics barn. No, we've got a fabrics barn here. Okay, I'm pausing for now. And we'll put that there. We'll see what these different barns take. Ah, crafted barn. No, that... Oh, maybe it will help. Crafted barn. Where was it? That's that one, wasn't it? Yeah, put it there. My goodness. And now nomads have arrived. And I misclicked. Oh dear. Yeah, we just made a situation worse due to a misclick. Why not just accept 47 new people while there's a famine going on? Ha 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 ha. Anyway, Ish and Tin. No worries, sorry. I was able to work out that the hunters are bringing bone meal in. I'll make tinned mutton here. You can't see me wagging my finger at this. Now that I know that I can make tinned fish, I could make another tinnery somewhere closer to our fisheries. Because that was a good discovery. Assuming I can actually squeeze it in somewhere. Ah, there. There's a little nook right here. There we go. Squeeze the a road in here as well. Stone. It's E. Oh no, we're using gravel in this area, but with that said, it's only a matter of time before I start upgrading. Yeah, in fact, let's just get the regular stone road, see how that looks for this area. So many starvations. Can't believe we've lost so many people to this death spiral. All probably due to that one loss of the root cellar. And let's go back to upping the number of farmers, shall we? Now. That's really bad. Whoa, what's the matter here? Have we just lost all our labourers? We have. Oh no. Everyone's dying now. Okay, emergency, emergency, emergency. Miners, that's another group we can reduce the workforce on for the time being. Can't reduce it all the way, though. Stonecutters, shoremen. Yeah, we'll reduce the shoremen, We reduce the stone cutters. We need the vendors. Less mouths to feed, but if they're not working in the food industry, then it's all going to be for naught anyway. My word. Quite probably one fire may have killed this colony. That's amazing. Let's have a look at the vendors. We need the vendors doing their thing. The tornado took out three people, two foresters and one labourer. So, luckily the tornado managed to avoid us for the most part. My goodness, this is really bad. But we should have the food in now, so maybe we're okay? No, we're not okay. We are really not okay. Through so much food. We're getting some food in at least, but it's good. Those numbers are dreadful. Well, hopefully these tinneries can save us, because man, we could really use the saving right now. Even the hunters are dying. Something else must have happened to have caused all these deaths. We lucked out with that tornado. The only thing I can think of is the buildings here, the fires taking out the root cellar. Yeah, there's nothing in the root cellars now. So bad. Yeah, which Pokemon did you catch? We need to get these, Whoa! We've lost all our chickens! How did that happen? Ah, well. Congratulations, Sorrow. dear. Okay. Let's have a good look at what we've got going on here. Dairy workers, distillers, dredgers. We don't really need the dredger too much, but it's better than nothing. Got a minimum number of foresters. The fuel refiners are low. Herdsmen are at capacity. Hunters. Oh no. It's still happening. Packers, physicians, potters, okay, preservists. The shoreman. Stone cutters, I'm gonna reduce. Tinnery workers, yeah, we need more of those. To make the most of our tinneries. Got a fair amount of building supplies and the like. Now what are you lacking? You're lacking the cheese. You've been producing cheese, so that's not too bad. We could just do with more of it. Now this I'm gutted about. Losing the chickens. I mean, we're still getting eggs and feathers. Oh dear. Right, do another foraging run. Now, once again, we're out of mutton. That's unfortunate. But you're making a bit of tinned meat each season, so it's something.